Hi everyone and welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to get started with Squish for Qt on Windows and Linux. I will be demonstrating that on a Windows operating system, but the basic workflow is mostly the same on both the Windows and Linux. This tutorial assumes that you have already installed Squish on your machine. To begin with, we will start the Squish IDE. So go to the Squish package directory. And double click on the Squish IDE.exe. If you're starting the IDE for the first time, then you will see the welcome screen. In order to dismiss it, click on the close button. The IDE will look like this then. This is the IDE without any test suite and test case. In order to create a new test suite, go to File, and then click on New Test Suite. This will bring up the Test Suite Creation Wizard. Here you can enter the name you want to give to your test suite. Let's say we call it suite_qt_example. And here you can enter the location where you want the test suite to be saved. Click on the Next button. On this page, you will see the list of the GUI toolkits supported by Squish. Choose the one using which the AUT was created. We will be using the address book example application for the purpose of this tutorial. This example application is shipped along with Squish. Since it's based on Qt, we will choose Qt here and then click on the Next button. Click Next. Here you will choose a scripting language in which your test case will be written. I will choose Python for this tutorial. Now click on the Next button. The final step is to choose the AUT that you want to test. Click on the Browse button to navigate to the location of the application's executable. Now click on the Finish button to create the test suite. You can see that the test suite is created here. Now you can create your first test case. For that, go to File and click on New Test Case. Enter the name you want to give to your test case. You will choose Script Test Case and click on the Finish button. You can see a new entry in the test cases view here. When you double-click on the test case, you will see that the editor will open with some default code. You're all set to record your first test case now. In order to start recording, click on this red record button next to the selected test case. This will bring up the AUT, and on the upper right corner, you will see the control bar. You can record some interactions with the AUT now. In order to stop recording, click on Stop Recording button here. This will bring you back to the IDE editor and show you the recorded code. In order to replay the recorded code, click on this Play button next to the selected test case. Once the test case has finished executing, you will see the results of that in the Test Results tab below the editor. That's all for today's video. Thanks for watching.